Hello everybody, welcome to a game called Aladdin for the Sega Genesis, based on the movie Aladdin, starring people I don't know, besides Robin Williams. I don't know who else is in it. Gilbert Gottfried, I guess.
Gilbert Gottfried, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, they do the voices, right? Gilbert Gottfried's a bird, I think, and Robin Williams is the genie. And
I bet you the other people were famous, too. I'm gonna look.
I've never seen this movie.
Have you seen any Disney movie ever in your life?
I saw some of Fantasia when I was a little kid. And I saw Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. I saw Cinderella. Or was it Sleeping Beauty? It was one of those. I think it was Cinderella.
I don't recognize any of these other voice actors, so... There you go.
But I don't know, I saw some live-action movies. I saw The Parent Trap, I think. No, that wasn't it. I didn't see that. I saw Freaky Friday. That's what I saw.
Yeah. Are you sure that's a Disney movie?
Yeah, the Jodie Foster one, I think, yeah. Oh. And I saw, like, what's it called? The one with, like, I think, who's in it? Don Knotts or someone like that? The Apple Dumpling Gang?
What?
I think I saw that. I saw that, a movie called that. And I remember we watched it when I was in school, and they showed it to all of us, and we were surprised because they said, like...
We're playing.
They were like, ooh, look, there's a girl? And we were like, wow, can you believe they're showing us that, you know?
Get all this?
It was like a more innocent time, viewers. Okay, so you ready? Even though I'm only 18, but
this is
you ready,
the whole
viewers?
Game. This is the whole game.
I mean, it was an older movie that they showed us. They showed us, like, when I was in elementary school. But when I was in elementary school, it was already...
Were you going to read that story?
A movie that was quite old at that time. All right. So anyway, Pants beat me in Ghosts and Goblins. No, he didn't. What am I talking about?
Look at this chest move.
No, that's not... Pants beat me not in Ghosts and Goblins. I beat him in that. He beat me in Hollywood Squares. And therefore, he got to choose this game. This is the game that Pants chose for us to play.
And we're going to just take turns playing.
So how are we going to do this? Is it going to be like when somebody dies, or is it we taking turns with levels? What are we going to do?
I think we should do both. Either or.
Okay. Should I start?
And we can break the rules, too. Yeah. Okay, so first learn what the controls are there.
Better tell the people who's playing when, you know? Okay, so viewers, this is run. This is me. This is me playing now, viewers. I'm starting.
They know this.
This is jump. This is run. This is rawr. This if is you, hey, how's it going, baby?
If you hear a keyboard, it's lime.
Yeah. This is pause.
Okay.
This is nothing. This is okay. Let's do that again. I gotta get used.
You did it all already.
Yeah, but I gotta know.
There's okay, jump
this
slash.
This is knife. This is jump. This is app. No, that's
apple.
Oh. Yeah, that is apple. Okay. We got it, viewers.
All right, go ahead.
Come on, babyface.
I wonder, it would be a weird game if we did it where, like, one person did the arrows and the other person did everything else.
I think it's better this way.
Yeah, it is. It would be interesting, though.
Kind of annoying, but yeah.
That's what would be interesting. Slash them. Or do that.
Okay.
Jump on that. Camel.
All right, viewer, come on, you don't have to tell me. No moments.
Okay. I'm going to have to stop you when there's a secret to make sure we get the thing.
It's allowed. Cool.
Those black pots, if you hit them, it'll kill everything. Not pots, lamps. It'll kill everything that's on the screen.
These?
Yeah.
Nice. Oh!
There.
Pants, I was going to kill that genie, but...
Yeah, those genie things are useful.
But he's obviously a good guy.
There's a bonus stage at the end that you use those with. You gotta stop standing underneath
those. I was trying to get my keyboard...
Holy.
...in the right position.
Keyboard in the right position.
There! What?
Alright.
Okay.
It's a good try, I guess.
Come on now. Okay, Pants has played this many times.
Whenever I played this as a younger person, I always wanted to go in, like, the holes, like, in that wall. I'm like, how do I get in there?
That's why because, is it there? Yeah, but you've always been fascinated by holes.
Okay. You mean, like, the hole in your laundry room?
Yeah, exactly, exactly. Okay, I think I can throw.
Yeah, you can. There you go. Yeah, there's really no need to really save your apples in this game. You get plenty extra. You can sort those.
Where's my health? Oh yeah, the thing is my health.
Yeah, those hands or arms with the pots and stuff. You can sort those.
I got a thing.
Yeah, heart.
I saw that.
Make sure you get those jewels.
That's what I got.
You got some more.
Whoa!
Hit the pot there.
That guy's...
Or the lamp, I mean.
No mames.
I don't want to... I want to get somewhere in the game.
I know. But I think you should let me do it.
Okay. You can hit those guys, by the way.
Whoa.
I don't know if that counts as a mame.
What guys?
Like the guys that are up above, to a point you can't reach, you can still hit them with your sword.
Well, I got health somewhere.
Yeah, I told you that.
Where was it?
When you fell down, it was on those stairs.
Okay.
I think you just landed on it.
It's too bad the Mexican runner doesn't watch us or know we exist. Since sure. I mention him all the time.
I have to tell you, start hitting those arms, because you keep dying by them.
Arms.
Not now, but before.
Oh, you can hit those?
Yeah, I told you numerous times, but you're not a great listener, so.
Some people have told me I am. Girls have told me I am.
Oh, Jesus. That's gotta be, I don't know.
Count for something.
I predict you die here.
Stop it! He's cutting my apples.
Yeah, that was pretty cool, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Good detail in the game. You did it.
This game is made by good people who know how to do it.
That's correct.
No mames! See, the reason I say that, viewers, is because the Mexican rummer says it all the time, so it's very catchy to me, you know?
Mexican rummer?
And so I start saying it. Well, he plays the flute, actually. That's probably
alcoholic?
A continue point.
Yeah, it is.
See, I'm figuring things out. You don't have to...
There's health.
Whoa!
See if you can get to it before you die. You can only get hit once more.
No mames!
How is that a mame?
Nice.
Whatever that is.
You dead!
Didn't we learn that no mames doesn't actually mean no spoilers?
It doesn't, but people take it as if it means that, though.
Well, that's what we thought at first, too.
Yeah, but in his videos, like he says, no hints, no spoilers, no mames.
Right.
You know, and people take it to mean that, even if they know it doesn't. So,
well, because it seems like it's the same
jerk. Come on.
Thing.
You suck.
Yeah,
get
try
in
jump.
Here. I'm telling you, go somewhere.
Thank did you. It.
Took him long enough.
Swear.
Nice. I like this. This is fun.
It's a great game.
Are you surprised I'm enjoying the game you wanted to play?
No, because it's...
Come on, shit face! Come on!
One of the best games on Sega.
That means it's Pants' turn.
Look at these graphics.
Yeah,
come on.
Good.
Look at the... They got shadows and everything. Come on.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's, you know...
It's intense stuff.
Typical for a Sega Genesis or something.
No, they don't have this much detail. This guy steals that, things from you, I think.
But it does have a great detail.
See, let me show you what I was talking about before.
Great animations, detail, everything, you know?
Oh, I can't. Oh, there's those things in the way, that's why. No, I can't.
Nice going, Pants.
You're going. Apparently, the good thing about dying is that you get to pick those jewels up again.
Good.
And with five jewels, you can... Whatever they're called. What are they called, I wonder? I think there's...
Have you beaten this game, Pants?
I don't remember. Either way, with five things, you can buy a new life.
Are there unlimited continues? I doubt it.
Definitely not, no.
How many are there?
A couple, but you can earn more. We will earn more, for sure. This is a bonus stage.
Yeah, I prefer this to Sonic, because Sonic moves too fast for me.
Okay.
I like a game where I could take my time. I don't like to run, and you know, everywhere.
You can take your time in Sonic if you want to.
Yeah, I know. Okay, fine. But I don't know, I just seem, I kind of
oh,
feel
here's
like
the dude we buy stuff from. See, this is, a, see, Wish, that's a continue. So we want that, right?
Yeah. That's better than a life.
Well, you,
that's why it
you
costs
get,
more.
You get 2 lives for 10, or 3 lives for 10. A continue is essentially 3 lives, right?
Sure.
So you get better value that way.
Of course.
I'm just gonna stay here. This is pretty cool. Wah! You got me. You got me a couple times.
Yeah.
You can make those dudes' pants fall down. That's pretty fun.
Oh, that? You complete the first level.
Alright, I'll do this bonus stage here. Unless you want to.
No, no.
It's complete luck. You just press...
You should go till you get killed, probably.
Oh, you don't ever want to play again?
Okay, fine if you think you're not going to get killed. Okay, fine.
That was kind of a joke, but...
I just thought we'd do it that way.
Okay. Well, I'll just give it, pass it over eventually. I'll just let, yeah, you can just start the next one. At some point in time, you're going to want me to play more often when it starts to get more difficult, I'm sure. Crap. I fucked that up.
I got to put a viewer language warning on it again.
I'm sorry.
Having escaped from the guards, Aladdin is approached by an ancient beggar. I'm sorry I didn't read it before, viewers. There's a cave, boy. A cave of wonders, filled with enough treasure to make all your dreams come true.
Look at how gnarly that guy looks.
To find it, you must find the two halves of a magic scarab. The first half is lost in the desert.
Oh, we can get it.
The desert.
Oh, there's a secret here. Let me show you. Watch this.
Find the scarab.
Are you ready?
Sure.
This is the secret. So you go over here. And then you go over here. Life.
Oh, I probably would have done that anyway.
Your turn.
I usually go everywhere when I play
there
games.
You go.
I check everything out.
Yeah, this level's fun, I guess. Watch out for those snakes with hats on.
I am.
Look, they just want to tongue you. You ever been tongued by a snake?
I don't like snakes, personally. What's
yeah.
that?
People who like snakes are kind of weird, aren't they?
I saw a big donkey. Oh, it's a cat.
I mean, I don't really know what the appeal is. Why would you do that to that nice camel?
How do I get up?
You just move.
But...
What does get up mean?
Oh, okay. That guy didn't do anything.
We should get an archaeologist out here.
Whoa!
Paleontologist, I can't remember which one.
Hemos.
Paleontologist, I think. Paleolufickers. Oh, did you see his underwear?
Yeah.
Classic.
This game is great. You picked a good game, James. I mean, pants.
Thanks. Is that like the 10th time, or...?
Hey, come on, you stupid thing!
Man, I wonder why some of those clouds are so much faster than the others. Look at that.
They must be those, they're circus clouds.
I think there's some sort of polar vortex up in...
Isn't that what some clouds are called, circuses, right?
I don't know.
I know there's a secret, there's more secrets in this level.
Yeah, there's one right here.
Because I have played this before.
You kind of just drop down, like, don't jump, just hold right, I think. Yeah.
That was great.
I think you got something.
Did I?
Not sure what, yeah. Do you have your sound on?
Oh, I don't hear anything. I better not do it.
Yeah.
I might mess up the video or something.
I don't have my sound on, so.
Stop!
Yeah, don't go that way. I like how there's a stop sign in the desert. It's pretty creative. Yay, underwear.
Yeah, pants, you have a thing for, like, underwear and pants at the end. I mean, that's probably why you named yourself that, right?
It's near and dear to me, yeah.
I missed it. The only thing I do complain about one thing, the screen doesn't scroll fast enough sometimes.
Yeah, it's, I agree. I don't know what, it's weird. It's finicky. I think pants has got to be one of the dumbest pseudonyms in the world.
Why did you pick it?
I didn't really think that far ahead. I didn't, you know, I didn't really think it would really come up ever again, you know?
You didn't think we'd be making videos?
Not really, no.
What did you think we were going to do, just look at each other?
Yeah. I figured you'd want to do
that. Oh, look at it. He's like, come here.
Yeah.
Come here, you dinky.
If you actually hear the sound, he actually says it to you. He says, come here.
Does he?
Come here. Yeah. Come here.
I like him.
There's a secret here. Let's see if you can find it. No. You're cold. Warmer. Colder. 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 Go down. Go right. Go left.
Go!
Nice. Now go up.
Perhaps?
I don't know what you got. You got something.
Yeah, maybe if I had something right on, I'd be able to hear.
Go down.
What?
Yeah, go down.
You've already done this.
To the left now, fool.
Oh, come
on. And then to the right.
What are you?
Oh, you just come back up. I don't know.
Mr. T or what?
Yeah.
Your dad's.
There's something down there. I think you should just go forward now.
How about I just play the game?
Okay.
Whoa! Weird.
Yeah.
He doesn't
you
know
push. You pushed that wall, man.
Did I?
Yeah.
Good.
Did you notice how Goofy is, Oh, wait, he's not.
Ow!
Maybe that's how you know there's a secret. I'm just learning. Whoa. If you see Goofy anywhere in this game, there's a secret. You know Goofy?
The dog.
Yeah.
His real name, his original name was Dopey Dog.
Not Pluto, though. Don't get him confused with Pluto.
No, I'm not.
Pluto is a dog that...
This part's hard.
...has a mouse for an owner.
Come on. How am I going to do this?
We just got to do better. Do you want me to do it?
No. Come on.
You can go to the left. That's where you want to go. No, up and to the left. When you're jumping on the palm trees, your last jump should be to the left.
Yeah, I thought I tried to do that already.
Oh, apple his face.
I think he's gone.
Me too.
Nope.
Oh, hello.
Okay.
When he's about to throw a knife at you, you're better off using your sword because you can block it with your sword.
I like games where you can explore like this.
Yeah. Oh yeah, get that. Gotta get it. Gotta get them all.
Guy's eating.
Aladdin. Yeah, he's a fat ass, isn't he? He just eats nonstop. I think you're throwing that at a wall. And now you have no apples left. Except you're gonna play with one. This is a timing thing.
Your turn.
Okay.
Find the scarab.
What is a scarab anyway? Do you know?
Yeah, it's like a... I think it's like... I don't know if it's always an ornamental thing or if it's an actual bug or something, but it's the thing they showed like at the beginning. It's this weird-looking insect bug thing.
Did Brendan Fraser have to get one?
But I think that it's in The Mummy.
Yeah.
I bet you there's
a scarab in there somewhere. It's got to be, right?
Probably. Maybe.
That movie's got scarab written all over it.
Yeah.
Right? All right, let's see
what... But I think it's more like an ornamental bug or something.
Let's pay attention to see what we get here. I bet you we get one of these jewels. Ready for it to go to 12B? There you go. There it is. You see it?
Yeah, that's a scarab.
It's half of it.
You got to get it.
I'm going to.
I almost got it. I couldn't have been that far.
Yeah, you were very close. I think you just needed to get past that big oof.
Yeah.
What am I trying to say? So, I had a thought the other day. Want to hear about it? Yeah. It's pretty uncommon, but you know, I guess that's why it
Look how
sticks
close
out.
I was.
Yeah, it's flying away. See how this thing here is goofy?
Yeah.
Instead of whatever else? It's because you're supposed to do this.
I didn't see it actually.
It's pretty weird, isn't it? You didn't see Goofy?
No.
Look at the... See the
Oh, I
wall?
do, yeah. So that's the thing that means there's a secret, eh? That's fascinating.
Well, in this case it does. I don't know why, but...
Because it's
I
true.
don't... I'm actually not sure how I found that this was a secret when I was younger, but it did. It just sort of happened, I think, by
Yeah.
luck. Anyway, I kind of think that there should be some requirements to be the king slash queen of England.
Okay.
Like, you should, every year you should have to be able to do, like, a pull-up or something. And if you can't do it anymore, you should just step down and the next person should take over. You know? Instead of them just having to wither away in old age as a king or queen. You know, they should be strong-ish. They shouldn't be weak. That's what
Well,
I'm
they
trying
don't
to
have
say.
to do anything.
Yeah, but just for pure symbolism's sake, they shouldn't be weak, I think.
I don't know about that.
Yeah, that's my opinion.
Well done, street rat. I mean, well done, street rat. The second half of the scarab is in Agrabah, in the possession of a clever thief.
That was short.
Agrabah rooftops.
Yeah, we're here. So,
This is how you play. Find the
well,
something.
go ahead.
What'd that say?
Scarab.
Again?
Yeah, you gotta find the other half.
Oh, right, he just said that. This guy sucks.
There's a secret here.
Everywhere there is.
I'll try to teach you how to do it.
Watch this.
You need to get that flute.
I
See
got
that
it.
one up there? Up above?
Yeah, I remember Deceased Crab trying to get that one up and he couldn't figure out how to get it, I
You
think.
have to fall down, you can't jump, and then press the jump button when you hit the spring. That's, you know how you sprung up to get there? Yeah. You gotta time it, like, so you press it as soon as you hit it. But you have to do it from a fall, for some reason.
This is the jump button?
Yeah. I think you might need to hit the end of it too.
The end of it.
The far end, you know, like
Oh.
where maximum leverage exists.
That's weird.
You jump so it won't work. You have to fall.
I know. All right. Missed it. This might take all day, viewers.
I think you can do it. It's not as hard as you're pretending. Almost, I think. That was close.
I think, yeah, I think I remember Deceased Crab trying to get that one up and he couldn't figure out how to get it.
Holy, now you just can't get up there. I think you should bounce twice on that. Okay, there you
It.
Should I do it now?
Sure.
I can't do it either. Oh, I thought I did it there. No, I can't do it. Oh, there, I did it, but I... You know what I mean? I bounced high enough, but I missed. Damn, this is not supposed to be difficult. I'm gonna blame it on the net play lag, like I always do when I can't do something. Idiot.
Ah, there.
F this guy. Go ahead. You know, when I went to pass the game to you, I actually like started handing my controller to you. And then I realized you can break that pot and it does something. Go back. I forget what. There's something inside of it. That one. Just hit it. There
I
you go.
know.
Genie. Yeah, I actually tried to physically pass you my controller. And then I realized that you're not here.
Right. Well, I am here.
You're here. Get in that hole.
What
I'm just
hole?
kidding. You can't get in that
Oh,
hole.
don't be silly. I'm trying to play a game here.
You ready to go on a magic rope ride?
No.
Are you going to go on one?
I'm ready. I already did.
This one's more magical.
Yeah, that was good.
Don't miss that thing.
What do those do again? Give you money?
Yeah, you can buy...
Where am I going?
Continues.
There it is. Hey, how's it going?
I swear you, like... It sounds like you're ringing your keyboard out. It's really interesting.
Ringing it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like you're trying to squeeze some sort of liquid out of it.
Oh, yeah.
I'm surprised it hasn't broken yet.
Are you serious?
Yeah, the way that you go at it. I mean, it doesn't really have any letters left on it.
Is it hard to get a new one?
No.
How much does it cost?
$15.
That's it?
Yeah.
Oh. Everything else is so expensive.
For a standard keyboard, anyway. You can get some expensive ones if you want. But
why?
They don't really do you any good.
Yeah, make sure if I have to get a keyboard, you...
You should get out of there.
Make sure if I have to get a keyboard, like, you, you remind me, you show me where to get, like, a $15 one, okay?
Yeah, okay. Break that thing.
Man, you're so demanding.
And then go to the left. But down below, where you tried to before. You remember? Yeah, no. So you go back and down.
See, look, he's telling me everything, viewers.
Well, you gotta do it,
You'd
man.
You'd be so banned from the chat. This is Mexican runner. Cool. Speaking of that, I watched
him play... No. Yeah. To whoa. Who was a farmer?
What?
Who was a farmer?
Wow, that was worth it. Okay, I watched him play... I was watching Who Framed Roger Rabbit.
A lot of great rope physics in this game.
You know?
I know who did. Jessica.
And right at the end of the game, he was trying to defeat the Doom guy. You know that Doom guy? If you've seen the movie, you'll know what I'm talking about.
I think I have seen it, but I have no recollection of it.
I have seen it as well, but I don't remember much of it either. It was a very long time ago.
Person.
But anyway, it's Christopher Lloyd. And Bob Hoskins was the star of the movie, and of course... But anyway, he was trying to defeat the Doom guy at the end, right?
Dude, what is this? Get on the rope.
All right?
Yeah.
And...
don't miss that.
He played the whole game, you know?
Okay.
And then someone told him right at the end, hey, use the pipe on the Doom guy. And then he did, and he beat the game, you know?
Okay.
And you should have seen his face. Like, he was so... There was no joy in his face at all when he beat the game.
Yeah.
Even though he'd been playing it for, like, 8 hours or something like that. It was a long one.
I bet.
Because this guy told him how to do it. You know?
Yeah, people suck, man.
And he said... And then he didn't say anything for a long time. He didn't say anything for a long time. And then he said...
you piece of shit, man.
He said, I am really mad right now. He says, I am really mad. He says, because seriously, he says... Oh, it's you. Okay, I wondered how that happened. Okay.
Yeah, I just had to do that. Go ahead.
Because he said... he says, if you don't want to watch my channel... He said, don't watch my channel. That's what he said. He said, seriously, he said, it makes me so angry when somebody spoils the game for me. He says, why do you do that? Why do you have to do that to me? Why do you have to do that? Just don't watch my channel if you're going to do that.
My turn.
That's what he said.
Yeah.
So he gets fed up with it. You can understand that, though, right?
Absolutely.
Because it's annoying, you know, he wants to do it himself, he's showing how he can do it, he's having a fun time, and then somebody says, oh, just do this, you know?
Yeah, that's BS.
And it's not the first time that's happened, as you know. You know, but that time he got more angry, because it's happened before, and he's like, please, and he said, please, he says, I have no hints, you know, no spoilers, it's right there. On every video, it's right at the bottom. He says, I don't know how I can make it any clearer than that. That's what he said, you know?
Yeah.
thankfully, most people respect his wishes.
That's
true. I don't like when people spoil it either. I want to see him try to figure stuff out. It's more fun that way when you're watching it too, you know?
I think the queen should maybe have a different task other than push-ups. I mean, what did I say? Pull-up.
Look at this.
The queen can do...
Is there a reason I'm not playing right now?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because this part is difficult. It's less difficult without the netplay lag, though.
Yeah.
Bonus game.
Oh, because it's another free life.
Bonus game.
Nice.
There we go. Go ahead.
Noice!
Yeah, noice, guys.
And, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank all the new viewers we've got. We've been getting more viewers lately, and I'm really happy about that.
You know, that might not be true, though, at the time.
So I like to thank everyone for...
I mean, it's true now.
...for subscribing, and I hope we keep getting...
There's some fun down there below. You better go down below.
What or why?
I don't know. It looks like there's got to be a reason.
I have to.
Got to. Then you can bounce on that thing for some reason. Let me see if this does anything. Hold on. Oh, look.
There's a light. Pants!
I'm sorry.
Now it's your turn.
Hey, look, it's still there.
Find the flutes, Pants. Not the scarab. Find the flutes.
Well, then you get the scarab. No, I guess you just find the flutes.
Pants, he doesn't even know.
Here you go. After we get this.
Baby.
Go. Baby. Your turn. I'm not sure what the queen should have to do to be able to keep being a queen. Okay, what are you doing?
He won't throw any... Oh, because I don't have any.
There you go. I'll keep slashing. You go get him. There you go.
I didn't have any apples. I thought I did, you know.
Yeah, you didn't. You just stood there and took a couple knives to the chest.
A lot. A lot.
Yeah.
Let's take a continue here.
You missed something back here.
I know.
Well, why didn't you get it then?
Okay, fine. Dude, you know what? I want you to play Kid Chameleon again and get every single thing there is, okay?
But I'm playing this game with you. This is a team effort.
I know. Well, you know what? We should play Kid Chameleon together.
Okay, fine.
We should do it as a team effort. I didn't know we could before.
There's a thing over there that you should get on.
Where?
The rope. There you go.
We should do that.
Yeah, okay. Oh, my. I'll let you blame that on the net play leg, because it probably
was. No, I'm not blaming
it. That's probably what it was.
Just me doing it.
No, I was in that point.
I'm not like you. Just... I don't blame other stuff all the time. Well,
it was it. I promise.
Okay. Hey, come on.
This is a guy that... Oh, yeah. It'd be good if you had apples. You don't, though. We're in trouble. You should break that.
I do have apples.
Oh, they're gone. More.
I can't break that.
This guy's hard to kill, I think, without apples.
This guy sucks!
Yeah, he sure does.
Well, you win! You play! I don't want to do this part!
Okay, I got it.
I don't like bosses.
Apparently this is how you do it.
Thanks, Pants.
There you go, your turn. Oh wait, there's something over here. Your turn.
Okay, so that was it.
Yeah, I showed that guy who wears the pants in this relationship.
Okay.
It's me.
You're weird.
Oh, hold on. Crap.
You just blew it. I was going to beat that guy and you blew it.
I know, but there was something that you missed. Can I get back?
No. Play the game.
We're so effed.
Because you're like...
You should have saved your apples.
Being anal. It'll give you more.
I know. You should have saved them, though.
Don't worry about it.
I guess you just died. I bet you there's some apples down below. I'm going to try to jump back since, damn it, net play lag.
See? Apples.
Oh, man.
Watch this out.
This is Donkey Kong.
It is. Oh, ouch. Pants. It's your turn.
Do I have to beat this dude again? I think I do. Nope. Just get the flute.
So, but we should do that. We should do a team thing on Kid Chameleon. That would be fun.
Yeah.
Like to do that with you.
What do you think the queen should have to do?
I don't really like this topic. I just seems a little disrespectful to me.
Why?
You know, to the queen, you know?
Well,
I don't think she have to do anything.
Wouldn't you rather it be turned over before, like...
But which queen are you talking about? Obviously.
Years and years of just withering away?
Apparently you talk about the Queen of England.
Yeah.
But what about the King of Norway? I mean, the King of Holland is what I'm trying
to say. Oh, I'm sure there's a King of Norway as well, you know.
But they just got a new king, what is it, last year? Or
okay.
I think last year Norway got a... Why do I keep saying that? Holland got a new king last year.
No offense to any Netherlanders, but no one gives a crap about their king.
Okay, so anyway,
because they didn't colonize the world.
Fleur, don't... his opinion does not matter to me. I mean, it does not reflect my opinion, so please keep watching our videos if you ever watch them. You know, I like to make a shout-out to let me ASMR it, whose name is Fleur.
Okay.
I wish she'd watch our videos. Could people please, can you please go to her channel and tell her to watch these videos? Like, seriously, is anybody ever going to do that? Please?
All right.
I'm sorry, viewers.
I suck.
I have asked you many times, and you haven't done it yet, as far as I know. Maybe you have done it.
Yeah, you don't know.
It just hasn't done it. With both halves of the scarab, Aladdin is ambushed unexpectedly by the palace guards. Now you're saying, why don't I do it? You're saying, you won't get away this time, Chief. But I don't know.
She looks sassy.
I don't know. It's the Sultan's dungeon for you. But viewers, if you want to do it, you don't have to do it. You don't have to do it. But if you want to do it, go tell, unhand that prisoner by order of the princess. Go tell, let me ASMR it. You know, that's her channel. Let me ASMR it. Oh, I didn't get to read that, Pants.
I broke that.
Did that too quickly.
Jasmine's eyes make up about one quarter of her face.
Hey, do I get to play?
You can if you want. You're going to hate this level. Go ahead.
All right.
Look how scared it is. Those things, yeah. Watch out for, see that bat?
He sucks.
Yeah, he does suck.
I don't think I ever got this far when I played it.
Yeah.
I don't remember this level.
Look at that. Depth or something.
Yeah, I've seen games like that.
So I can see this is going to take a while, I think. These block things.
Of course. I've played... There are a lot of games that have this mechanic, you know. Whoa! Come on, dude! Don't just throw bones at me.
Nice work. You've got to hit him before he does that.
Well, I boned him.
Yeah, you blocked him. That's good.
Boned his bones.
Oh, look, you missed that. Okay. Yeah, who cares? That's fine. I think you're safe there.
Missed everything. Whoa. Oh.
Look at that weird thing. You see it?
Yes, what are you doing?
I'm not doing anything.
Who did that?
I didn't do anything.
Something weird was going on with the game.
I think it might have been all in your head.
No, it was like a slow motion all of a sudden.
I don't know. Lag.
Oh, come on. The heat box. You know, I should have been able to land on that.
Yeah.
Come on! Okay.
There you go.
Not as hard as I thought. Whoa. You impressed?
Yeah, you got the timing down, I think. Oh, no, you're safe. Next time a guy is going to try to explode, you got to go whack him with your sword.
Whack-a-mole.
Sure.
Where am I going?
That way.
Down here?
Of course.
Ow, see.
Not into that.
He doesn't stop either sometimes. I mean, he does, but he slides a bit.
Yeah.
He's a
slide. Yeah, slide. I think he doesn't slide if you just press left, you know, instead of just letting go.
Can I go over here?
Yeah.
Where did I go?
I don't know. I guess there's no point in going up there. Oh, you better, you're gonna die.
Am I?
Wow, somehow all those bones missed you.
Oops.
Don't do that in real life. If some, like, guy with a bomb, you know, comes up to you, run away. Don't just stand there and look at him. Wow. Okay. Good work. Dude. I don't know how you keep not getting hurt. It's good, I guess.
You like?
I do like.
Thanks, Judy.
You're welcome, Marcia.
My name is Fleur. No.
Did I get that right? Is Judy in that show?
Brady Bunch?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
Oh. Who's Judy Dencher? Judy Denton?
Isn't she like an older woman?
I don't know.
Actress?
Am I saying the name correctly?
Thanks for not grabbing that, dude.
We're not playing Flashback anymore.
I think it's Judy Dench, by the way.
Oh. I was close. It's kind of a neat
Come
name.
On!
It's me.
I'm gonna skip everything.
I think you should get up there.
Get
like
out.
Now.
This way?
This way.
Let's go, what do I do here? Alright.
That's good.
It just does it automatically, that's good.
Yeah, it does.
Alright. Now let's,
throw an apple at that guy.
I can't.
Yeah, you can.
Did it.
You don't need to throw 9, you know. Just one.
Come on, man. It's my style.
Hold on 1 second. Hold on. Hold on. Stop moving. Oops.
You're great, Pants. You're wonderful.
I'm sorry.
Thanks for ruining my fun here.
I'm totally sorry.
You've done that. That's not like the second time you've done that.
Yeah, it is. I'm not the person who got rid of all the health before that.
I know. Why do you take over that moment so I'll get all mad at you?
Because you keep deciding to skip things.
I'm not deciding. I just don't know, you know?
Oh, there's actually nothing down here.
Oh, great pants. But I like it when people explore in games. So I'm happy.
Your turn.
Oh, yeah?
Go touch Robin Williams. That's some interesting acrobatics.
There's a bat.
Yeah. Can you imagine if someone could actually do that in real life? It'd be incredible.
It's like what you used to say when you played Donkey Schlong.
I don't recall.
You used to say that if you could do that, like, when you're the monkey, you could do that in real life.
That when he hammers the ground?
Yeah, some of the stuff that I did as a monkey. You know, I did some incredible things.
Oh.
We should play that sometime, viewers.
Of course we should. Yeah, well, if we didn't have to always keep playing your dumb games, we would.
Come on, man.
Why?
Well, we'll get to it eventually.
Yeah.
After we play every Nintendo game.
You're probably missing something, but...
Or maybe, you could always pick it, too, if you win a challenge again.
Yeah, you could pick it.
I know. Did I achieve anything?
No. I guess you're supposed to go down.
Why'd I even do that?
I don't know. Heart. Whoa. Bizarre. Okay, there's something... Don't forget to go to the left. There's nothing there.
You're like a backseat driver. Okay. And now I'm getting batted again.
Use your sword. You never use it.
Yes, I do. You're sort of like a backseat driver, man.
Yeah, I know, but I... You should be a backseat driver if the driver doesn't stay on the road.
Well, don't you just want to see how I do without, like, saying stuff?
No.
Fine.
I want to progress in the game.
Yeah, good for you, babyface.
Viewers want us to progress as well.
That's good. I hate this guy. Oh, that sucked.
Good try.
Your turn. Well, that's nice of you. I'm sorry, sorry, viewers.
You should be. You're acting like a jerk. I'm gonna move. You're allowed to talk, though, if you want. I'm gonna die. I'm alive. Ooh, I'm alive. For at least 5 more minutes.
Yeah, the reason I say that is because I'm a big fan of Let Me ASMR at Fleur.
Yeah, and I'm a big fan of the Queen.
I really am, though.
Why don't you tell them? Oh, yeah. Well, they know who you like. If they pay attention.
And they know that I love Kat Dennings. She's my girlfriend.
Right.
They all know that. That's Line Popsicle 101. That's the first thing you learn on the first day of class. That I love Kat Dennings. And that...
But she's biased towards me when it's video games time.
What?
She's biased towards me.
That was only one game.
You know what's... Kat Dennings has, like, really huge lips.
You didn't think he was going to say that, did you, viewers?
They're abnormally large, I think, for a person.
Oh, they're beautiful. I love those lips.
Of her genetics.
Great lips. Yeah, they are very large lips.
Yeah. Large lips are,
They're great, though. You see, when I kiss her, I can't stop kissing her, because that's when I keep doing it, you know?
It's good, but the thing is that, you know, your lipstick costs are through the roof.
Well, she uses a lot of lipstick, too, because she likes to have bright red...
She probably spends a lot of money on lipstick.
Lips, yeah.
Damn it. Why is this happening? Why is this happening to me? Is this going to be forever? Hey, Lime.
A lot of people don't realize that Pants is actually his cousin.
Uh-oh. Did you just break the game? Oh, it's back.
No, see, that's what happened when I was doing it, too. But you didn't notice it. Something
I guess not. I mean, you do sometimes just stand there for no reason, so it must have been where my confusion came from. Oh, look at that.
People don't realize, but David at the dentist is actually... And that's his name, by the way. He changed his name legally to David at the Dentist.
As he should.
Yeah. So you if you see him, you call him Mr. at the Dentist. Yeah, well, he's Pants' fifth removed cousin on his mother's side.
Fifth removed?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm making that up, viewers. Don't believe
me. I didn't want to remove him, but they made me.
Yeah. Give me the script. Thanks, Oops. Pants.
So...
No story time for the viewers today.
Here's the thing. We got a lot of, like, continues. Like, 1,000, 1,000,000.
Great.
Do you want to do this one? It's pretty hard.
Fine, you go.
Well, do you want to do it?
Fine, you go.
Yeah, but do you want to do it?
No.
I mean, you've played the whole game, basically, so far.
I don't care. Whoa.
You're doing well.
This isn't me playing.
Yeah, I know that.
This is you.
Look at that guy. I think I want to get it. What? Oh. You need to whack those guys, I guess. I don't really remember. You whack the monkey statues?
Yeah, I'm playing now.
Look, it's a heart.
Here we go.
Oh, boy. You sure about that?
Your turn.
Okay. Hit the statues. Did you see that?
Yep.
I didn't the first time.
I can see. Didn't I say
miles
that?
And miles
didn't I say
and
if you would hit the statues? Didn't I say that at the beginning? I thought I did.
I don't remember.
Maybe I didn't.
I wish you could move and sword at the same time.
Yeah.
That'd be cool.
Some games you can do that.
Yeah. Oh, look at this lady. Oh. Whack! She's a statue, right?
She's kind of, not bad looking.
Oh, yeah? Do you see all those bats that just came after me?
Of course I did. What do you think I am?
A blind bat?
I'm not blind. I can see it.
I can't. Look at this little effort.
Just grab hold of the thing and then do it.
Yeah, that's right. That's going to break, isn't it? No?
No.
Probably would have. I think it was going to break. It looked very...
Precarious.
That's right.
Whoa,
doesn't look stable. Is that a statue? Oh, she's throwing shit at me. What a bee.
No, she's not.
A bee snatch.
Well, I disagree. Wait!
What?
Don't use language like that.
Which one?
I'm not saying it. The second one, especially.
Bee?
No, the second one.
Bee is for what?
But that one's not good either.
What is bee for?
Neither one of them is good. Didn't that show get canceled?
Sesame Street?
The Bee in Apartment C?
I don't know.
Whatever it's called. Stupid show.
Let's do the alphabet.
I think A is that whole show got canceled.
Aladdin. What's B for?
Alright, well, you keep playing. We'll do the alphabet.
Okay.
B.
Oh, that weird thing.
Is for a bouquet of flowers.
Disagree.
What?
I disagree.
I'm not playing anymore then.
Alright.
You want to say something bad.
What? I want to say something good.
Like what?
Like I'm going to die.
That's bad, see? Okay, viewers. Write down pants is in a cave.
Write in the comments what B is for.
Beat Chef.
B is for Beat Chef?
I don't know if he watches our videos anymore.
Alright, deal. B is for Beat Chef.
I think he disappeared.
I think he's going to find that really bizarre thing for you to say.
Well, he hasn't made a comment on our latest one.
He's going to be like, what the hell is
Ghosts
wrong?
And Goblins, I don't know. So I'd like to make a shout out to some of our other subscribers who are watching our videos now.
Me too, let me do it first. I want to say thanks to...
Yeah, I know where you're going.
No, you don't. Thin Fried Tofu for the suggestion of a gamepad. So that it's not so loud.
Do you have a gamepad now?
Yeah. Do you hear a keyboard? I realized that I always had it.
Oh. Yeah, so Pants has a gamepad now, Thin Fried Tofu.
Wait. That's me. My Popsicle will have one eventually.
If Pants buys me one, yes.
Yeah, I'll have
one. I'm not buying it. The next thing
Ow.
I want to say is a shout out to Jonathan R. because he's a great viewer. If he still watches the videos, he's a great viewer. He didn't comment either on the latest video, so.
Whatever.
I don't know, man.
Some people have lives, you know?
And I'd like to make a shout out to Angie Reed, who you've been really nice, and it's nice to have a girl that watches our videos. I assume there are more girls that do.
Yeah, they feel somehow harder to acquire, don't they?
Yeah, they usually are, though, in real life, too, so, you know. In everything, right, viewers? And if you're a guy, you'll know what I mean. Anyway, it's hard to get a girlfriend, that's what I'm trying to say. So anyway, Angie Reed, thanks for watching our videos, and I'm glad that you really like me. I don't mean like that. I just mean you've said some nice comments and everything, you know.
Yeah, maybe you guys should go on a date.
No, she's, she's got a boyfriend already. And he's also, he sent me a message asking me for a birthday present. I don't think I'll go into all the details here. Because I don't know if it's supposed to be private or not. So, you know, but basically he had a neat idea for a birthday present, which I was happy to comply with for his girlfriend, who turned out to be Angie Reed, and I didn't know it was her. Because I knew she watched our videos, but I didn't know that was his girlfriend, that he was, you know, and she just told me days ago. You know, she sent me a nice thank you note. So, Angie Reed, I'm glad that you watch our videos. You know, you said some nice things that I'm adorable and things like that. And I definitely like to hear a girl say that I'm adorable. I want more girls to say that. So, if you're a girl and you think I am, please tell me that, you know. Mm. If you're a guy or a girl, Pants will be happy with either one, I think. Am I right? Now, you speak for yourself, Pants.
I don't know how to respond to that. I'm just going to ignore it, I think.
I'm just teasing Pants, Spears. I'm teasing Pants. Pants, do you want to, like, clear up anything?
I'm a pretty big fan of Dora the Explorer.
Alright, yeah, Dora the Explorer, exactly.
I don't know what the hell I'm supposed to do right now.
So anyway, I do like it. Girls, if you think I'm adorable, please tell me, because, you know, it's a nice thing for me to hear. You know, it's not something I hear very often, so.
What the hell?
You know, so I appreciate it. That's what I'm trying to say of yours. I appreciate it.
Did I already do what I was supposed to? Am I supposed to just go back now?
And all you dudes that watch my videos, I'm, of course, very happy to have all my dude friends watching my videos. All the cool guys that watch the videos, as well as the cool girls, of course, which I already mentioned.
Yeah, you sure did.
So all you, every subscriber, except for the ones that are jerks, and most of you aren't. Most of you aren't. In fact, I haven't been aware.
Look at this weird naked monkey.
I haven't even been aware that any of you are jerks, except for one guy. But besides that, and I'm sure, okay, here's how it goes, viewers. Let me tell you, let me just be frank with you. What happens is if you start to become popular on YouTube, you're going to get some jerks as well as good people, you know, watching your videos. But that's what happens with popularity. There's always going to be some people who don't like you. Some people. Now, I'm not saying I'm popular. Think I'm becoming conceited here.
That's exactly what you're saying.
No, because I'm not saying that. I don't think I'm popular. I don't think I'm popular. I mean, if, you know, it'd be nice to be popular, you know, maybe that might happen someday. Who knows? But
ouch.
I don't feel like, you know, but I got more subscribers. We've got more subscribers than I thought we were. You know, I'm so gratified that we have all the subscribers we have. It's beautiful. And I hope they grow. I hope we have 5 billion subscribers, you know, someday.
This part's difficult, apparently.
Yeah, so I just want to say, viewers,
frick,
that you know, but when, of course, you know this, viewers, that if with any degree of fame, not that we have, like, fame or anything, but you're going to have people.
This is such a dumb part of everything.
Who are jerks, you know. So there is, like, one dude that made some kind of, you know, strange comments. But anyway, that's fine. That's
fuck
fine.
You, fish.
Sort of. So anyway, we love all of you. All of you, except for maybe, like, one or two people.
Jesus.
We love the rest of you. Right, Pants?
Sure.
And that's the end of that.
I just can't wait for it to be over.
Done.
All right.
All right, Pants, you do the next monologue. Go.
Today on the show, it's a real big show.
Let me do my Ed Sullivan?
Yeah.
Okay. I love doing Ed Sullivan impersonation for years. If you don't know who that is, look him up on YouTube. You see videos of him. He had the best-selling...
Damn it.
The biggest variety show on television throughout the 50s and 60s. Okay. So, that's the short thing. And if you heard of the Beady Dum Dums, right? Did I say that right?
No.
They made their American live debut on his show, and it was one of the highest rated shows of all time. Okay, so a very famous moment in television history. And Elvis, let's not forget. I'm a bigger fan of Elvis. I'm not really a fan of the Beady Dum Dums, but I'm a fan of Elvis. And as you know, if you listen to any of my songs, because sometimes I impersonate Elvis, you know, sing his songs. But anyway, the real Elvis has showed up, like, in an LP at least once. And I've been talking to him. This is actually some news views. I've been talking to Elvis, okay, because, you know, he doesn't tell everybody where he is or anything because, you know, people don't know if he's alive or not. But I've been talking to him, right? And he said that he wants to do an LP with Pants. So I've been working something out. We've been talking about the LP. We've been negotiating it. And he wants to watch Pants play a game. Because he's
yeah, but show. he wants 50% of the proceeds, and that's just not fair.
No, that's good. You know what? He'll do it for free because he's not like that. Elvis isn't like that. Colonel Tom Parker is the one that was all the money, you know. It's like, we got to do it this way, you know. And Elvis did things he didn't want to do because he felt indebted to Tom Parker, you know. He made movies he didn't want to make, you know. He'd barf. He literally barfed when he read the scripts to some of his movies.
So you're saying that he doesn't demand 2 cents compensation.
Elvis was one of the most insecure people that you could ever meet. And, you know, he couldn't believe he was so famous. He just couldn't believe it, you know.
I couldn't either.
It never went to his head. It just, he was like baffled by it, like, whoa, you know. Right? He was such a down-to-earth guy.
Yeah, it's pretty baffling.
You know, he was always grounded. He never got like Justin Bieber or anything like that, you know, where he like went to his head, you know. And hey, I met Justin Bieber.
Don't you talk about Justin Bieber that way.
For real, viewers, I met Justin Bieber before he was famous at a talent show.
You know how many times you've mentioned that?
Not that many, I don't think.
I'm going to guess about 47.
I'm
going to
bet that a lot of viewers don't know this, so I'm going to tell them briefly. Viewers, I met Justin Bieber at a talent show just before he got famous. Just before. I met him and his mom. His mom was telling me, you know, about they had a YouTube channel, had all these subscribers, and he was trying to get a recording contract and all this stuff. And back then, you know, his mom was really nice. I talked to him for a long time. I walked around the fairgrounds with them a bit and everything. This is a true story. I'm not making this up, you know, because I make things up sometimes, but this is true. And you know, he was fine, but he seemed too obsessed with becoming famous. Like, at that time, I could tell, like, well, he lost the contest. He didn't go farther in the talent search, right? He didn't get to the finals, and he was really, really upset about it. Like, he just was like, we're going home. This is it. We're going home. Like, he was really didn't like that, you know, viewers. And his mom said, this is the hardest part, you know, basically trying to, you know, console him or whatever, talk to him when he loses something.
The hardest part is that I have a whiny little bitch for a son.
So, I don't know if he should went that far, because if he hears this, you know, he could sue for slander or something.
I don't care. Screw him.
So anyway, but his mom is the same, well, I almost said, okay, his mom
yeah,
is
she's
nice.
Not.
What?
She's not what you were going to say.
She's definitely nice, and he seemed okay, but, you know, he's too focused on, I gotta be famous, I want to be famous, this kind of thing, you know.
I did it.
But I, you know, and again, I don't, it's not my type of music. Now, back to Elvis. I like Elvis.
It's my type of music, baby.
Elvis is great. Okay, so, I'm talking to Elvis, and Elvis said that, said that he wants to Pants to play a game because, you know, he's not really, like, good at playing video games. He didn't grow up with video games. There weren't any, obviously. And, you know, it wasn't until after he died that they became popular. So, you know, he never played too many, you know? I mean, but he's alive, obviously, because he's going to be in an LP with Pants. So I'm hoping this is going to happen soon. So he's going to commentate with Pants, and I'm going to introduce it at the beginning. I think that's how we're going to do it. So Pants, hopefully we'll do that soon. You like that, Pants?
Yeah.
Okay.
I won. I didn't know you could beat the bonus levels, but
so
I
now
did.
I'm going to do my Ed Sullivan impersonation. Okay.
All right.
Here we go. Finally, after all that. Okay.
Yeah. You got to read this as Ed Sullivan.
What? Okay. Hold on. You have touched a forbidden treasure. Now you will never again see the light of day. That's right.
That doesn't sound good.
It sounds perplexing.
Perplexing?
Now right here on our show, on a really big show for you youngsters out there in the audience, we have a really special guest. His name is Pants. You're going to be playing a video game for you, for all of you. What? Wait a second. Is somebody in my audience? Should I take a bow?
Ouch.
Pants, just hold your pants back there behind the stage. Because right here in my audience, we have a really special...
This isn't going so well.
This is Broadway actress. She's now starving on Broadway. Starring on Broadway. She's certainly not starving, as you can see. Oh, I'm sorry.
Fat?
Quite sorry about that. That's right. Now, take a bow. Stand up here. Come on up here. Take a bow. Let's give her a big hand. Come on. Let's hear it for her. Come on. All right. I didn't say her name. Her name? I forget. Okay, so Pants... right here in our... Oh, what's that? What? We're out of time? We're out of time for this shoe? The Ruby Shoe Pants? Hopefully you can come back next week. Oh, wait a second. What? What's that? We have time? Okay, Pants, come on out here and do your stuff. Come on, Pants.
I'm jumping over holes.
So there's a bit of my Ed Sullivan. I feel like that Ed Sullivan I just
I'm
did
dead.
Different than every other time I've done him.
Okay.
It just felt like, I don't know, it sounded different to me than it usually does when I do Ed Sullivan. That's really weird.
Yeah,
I don't know if it was more accurate or less accurate. I'm not really sure.
It's more Activision.
Hey, the viewers can let me know.
Wow. My timing here is just not on, you know?
I paid a fool that didn't eat his apples.
Uh-oh.
That was Mr. T.
Sure was. I just jumped into a hole for no reason. Did you see that?
And by hole, I have seen this part of the game before. I've
giant pit of lava.
It's very difficult at this point, as you can see, viewers.
Yep.
No, my base. Did you hear what I said that time?
You said no, my base.
You do it, yeah, you got it. All right, Pants. Now, if you were actually in a lava pit, what would you do?
Go left. I mean, he's just running further and further into the lava pit, isn't he?
This is, and of course, everybody's going to be thinking at this point, this is Indiana Jones. Because anytime people run from big boulders, they say, Indiana Jones ripoff.
Well, you can't. Only one person's allowed to do that. Jeez.
All right, this LP's probably going to last too much longer, viewers.
I think we got quite a few continues left, to be honest.
Okay, well, let's see you get farther, Pants.
The net play lag is, it's too much. Do you believe that's a thing?
No.
I didn't expect you would. The net play puts a 100 millisecond delay on every button you press to make sure that the game stays in sync.
Something the viewers might be interested to know. Is it all right if I tell the viewers that what you're working on?
I don't know what it is.
Well, you're an amateur programmer. Is this correct, Pants?
I guess so.
Do you want to tell them about the project you're working on?
No.
Can I tell them what you're doing?
I don't think you know.
Well, Pants is, can I say this?
You can say whatever you want.
Pants is developing a video game in real life.
No, in fake life.
And,
wow, there's a hole there.
On it for, how long have you been working on it, Pants?
7 days.
I think he's been working it for like a year or two or three or something. I don't actually know because he never tells me anything. But he is actually trying to develop a game that he hopes to market someday. So I don't know what it is, what kind of game or anything, but it's got to be one of those newfangled games,
damn.
You know? Because he's definitely not going to be making one of those independent, you know, two-dimensional games. It's probably like some hardcore, like, 3D Halo-type thing or something. I don't know. I have no clue. I really don't know. I'm just, but he wants to market it, so he wants to try and make money. So it's probably got to be something crazy, you know? Because this day and age, you got to have something crazy to make money, right? I mean, they can't make, like, just fun games anymore. They have to be, like, you have to be like, whoa, I'm in outer space playing this game. The graphics are so great. I think I'm hurtling along at light speed through the highways of time. You know, that's what the games have to be like today. Right, Pants?
In actual reality, the simpler games have a much better return on in money, at least for independent developers. Because you can't compete with game that has a, you know, $500 million budget as a single person. You're not going to make a game as good as they are.
So you're making an independent game?
Well, of course I am.
But you don't work for a multinational corporation?
What I'm trying to say is that mobile games are the most lucrative games.
The games made for oil companies?
No, not lubricative.
You said mobile.
Oh, like an automobile.
Well, there's an oil company called Mobile, or Mobile.
Yeah, Mobile.
Have you ever heard of that?
Exxon Mobile.
There you are. Are you think you're going to beat this level, Pants?
Yeah. That's the hard part right there. It'd
be nice if the it scrolled more so you could see where you're jumping.
It'd be nice if there was a continue, or I mean a checkpoint somewhere in this level.
That'd be nice too.
All the parts leading up to that aren't nearly as hard as I've been making them out to be.
There's an unlicensed...
That's a netplay lag.
There's an unlicensed NES game.
Holy.
There's an unlicensed Nintendo game.
I don't know what
game.
That was.
Called Aladdin 3 or something like that, and it looks like it was made by, I don't know, it looks like Action 52 Aladdin, basically. It's pretty crazy. It's pretty crazy.
I'm kind of annoyed by how much I suck right now. I need to just slow down and pay attention to what the hell I'm doing.
It's got no nose. Yeah, you do. You got one.
Yeah, I got one. I wish I had two, but...
Really?
Yeah.
Why?
So that I could smell my other nose. Just, you know... Just an infinite loop of smelling noses.
Hey, you know what? If any of you viewers are so inclined and you feel like making a highlight video of our greatest moments from our LPs, feel free to do it.
Right.
I'd like to see that.
And this part won't be in it, probably.
And and also, viewers, if you don't know where our LPs are, just go to the playlist section, and there is a Lime Popsicle and Pants... playlist. Let's
I'm inclined to say not only do that if you want to, but do whatever the hell you want. Right?
Yeah. But anyway, you'll find all of our playlists with Lime Popsicle and Pants in the playlist that's called Let's Plays with Lime Popsicle and Pants.
What I meant was do whatever the hell you want with our material.
Well, obviously, yeah. Good job, Pants.
Thanks. Oh.
Yeah, just, you know, you don't have to run anything by us. Just go ahead and pick out what you think are the funniest parts of the LPs. That'd be really cool. I'd like to see someone do that.
Yeah? You want to do the rug ride?
I don't know, those kind of levels are difficult for me.
Yeah.
I don't think I want to do this.
I forget what the apples do. I guess they just sort of guide you.
And this is going very quickly.
No, they don't.
Oh, I remember this level. Yeah,
I got an extra life. That was cool.
I remember this. I don't know if I played this or if I just watched other people play it. Because there's no way I beat that last level without save states. And again, viewers, I don't use save states anymore. I don't recommend that you use them. You know, because it takes the fun out of gaming, in my opinion. Because anybody can beat a game with save states. You know, it's not that exciting.
Yeah, totally.
And it ruins the game, because then, you know, you see the whole game without, you know, by cheating, so. It's no fun.
Oh, too slow.
I wish I had never used them so that I hadn't seen, you know.
There was an awful lot of extra lives in there. Is it the apples that speed you up? Am I supposed to avoid all the apples?
Ah, you should know the answer to that, Dobie Gillis.
I guess I should just keep getting that extra life that's there. Like, they don't actually try to make this a difficult part of the game. I mean, they make it annoying, but they expect you to beat it by, if you just try it enough times, I guess. I don't know. Dobie's the name of my staircase. Gillis is the name of my fish's back door. Uh-oh, I went the wrong way. Do you ever get itchy boobs?
I don't have them.
Do you ever get
itchy... Neither do you.
Do you ever get itchy,
That always bugs me when guys say that they have breasts because they don't, you know?
Do you ever get itchy, What is this part of?
I mean, I know some heavier people have... I don't know what you call them, but I would not call them that. I don't like that term for...
Do you ever get...
For men, itchy, I don't like it, because men don't have them. Men do not have those.
Do you ever get itchy pectoral muscles?
I don't think it very often, I don't think.
What am I doing? I do. I have itchy pec syndrome.
But you're itchy everywhere.
That's true.
You always tell me that. You're itchy.
Yeah, it's true. Whoa. I'm gonna die. Uh-oh.
Wrong way, that was up.
Yeah.
You want me to tell you which way? I'll interact with you.
I don't think it's gonna help. Apparently I won anyway.
You did?
I guess. There must have just been something special at the end if you made it far enough.
Well, that's great, Pants. In the last instant before freedom, the mouth of the Cave of Wonders collapses, trapping Aladdin and Abu inside. When Aladdin inspects his prize, he is suddenly swept into a strange world within the lamp.
Oh, yeah. This would be a fun one for you.
I'm playing?
Sure.
Inside the lamp.
I think this is where the genie, like, does a bunch of weird, goofy stuff.
We should play Radical Rex again this time.
I'm going to go pee.
Have a good
Is that allowed? Time. Look, you can go down there. I'm not sure what it's for.
Oh, there's a thing.
Yeah, go down.
I'll do everything.
Go down right there. No,
come on, man. Go to the bathroom.
Go over there. Go over to the left, man. I want to know what's over there. Okay. That's it. I'm taking over.
Get him to go to the bathroom.
There's just a couple apples there. Alright, I'm leaving.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
See you. Alright. Just jump. What? Alright, viewers. I like it when games don't... Oops. Don't tell Pants about that, viewers. Yeah, don't tell him. I didn't mean to do that, so... Wait. Where's that... Where was that that... Did I bounce off of this, viewers? Was it the hand? What did I bounce off of before? When I was up high, remember? Oop. Don't tell viewers. Don't tell Pants about that one either. I don't know how to get up there anymore. I did it once. Wait. I'm gonna get these apples, you know? I'm not sure what else to do. Whoa! Oh, I messed it up. Okay, wait. Oh, there it is. What? How do I do it again? Viewers? I don't know. What? What? How did I do it? I don't get this, viewers. Okay, viewers, I'm sorry. I don't know what I'm doing. I know this isn't really... Whoa. Exciting, because... I don't know what to do. Pants is gonna... Oh, frick! Viewers, I'm so sorry! Oh. Really? Oh, I know what to do. Oh, Pants is gonna see I didn't get anywhere. He's gonna be like, no! This is hard. Viewers, this is... Oh. Viewers. Oh, wow. I don't even know what... Viewers, I don't know what to say. This is so difficult. I think Pan should play this level. What do you think, viewers? That's what I think. He's back, viewers.
Did you die? Or have you just been...
I died several times.
Oh.
I died about 5 times.
That's not good.
I told the viewers not to tell you, but I'm sorry.
Wasn't I gone for like a minute?
Yeah, but I fell in holes all the time. I don't know what to do. You play.
Okay.
I'm stuck.
You know what would really suck? Not having eyelids.
For sure. The reason we have eyelids is...
They're good for so many things.
Yeah. Well...
Sleep?
Yeah, we have them for that. And we have them to keep things out of our eyes.
Yeah. To save yourself from sandstorms.
Well, that's what you're supposed to do.
And,
I couldn't figure it out.
And, you know, like not seeing unfavorable genitals and stuff.
What? Not seeing unfavorable genitals?
Yeah.
Is that what you just said?
Yeah.
Okay.
If you didn't have eyelids, you know, you'd have to turn your head to not see
genitals.
It's
funny that you went there, though. It's like, it's funny you could just say, you just close your eyes to see things you don't want to see.
That's what I said.
I mean, you made it more specific, you know?
Wow, that's just...
You always got genitals on the mind, don't you?
Of course.
Okay.
Viewers,
pants is not for children.
Chickens? Well, are you saying that children should wear pants?
Of course they should.
Okay. Well, try not to say that next time. I bet you there's something special here.
I'm saying pants should... Of course children should wear pants. What are you talking about? You're weird.
Chickens have breasts, and I like to eat them.
Well, you know what, viewers? I don't know if pants is trying to make this awkward or what, but...
Chickens are females, though, aren't they?
I don't
know. Do you know what a male chicken's called?
A rooster?
Yeah. I wanted to bring it full circle, though.
Okay.
Do you know what they're called?
I heard, like, someone's making bras for chickens.
Yeah. Isn't that what a Chick-fil-A is?
No. That's the place where you eat them.
Aren't you a fillet? A fish? I better get an extra life. What do you think? How do I get it?
I watched a whole bunch of old... Let me ASMR videos. Let me ASMR videos early.
Oh, that's how you do it.
Tonight.
That's pretty sweet, wasn't it?
Just so you know. That's Flair again, I'm mentioning.
Hey, look at that. And that. I fixed the game that you broke.
Remember the time, viewers, when I wrote, like, the description and or part of it and the title in Dutch?
Wow. I went in a hole.
Remember that, viewers? The reason I wrote in Dutch is because I was trying to... I thought maybe if I do it in Fleur's native language, it would entice her to come over here, you know? But I don't think she's been here yet.
Come over to your house?
Well, I meant the videos, you know?
You should have put your address in Dutch in the... Which doesn't even make sense, really, does it? What did Dutch people use for numbers?
Oh, well, I've heard a Dutch ASMRist talk, teach the numbers in Dutch, but I can't remember what they are, but I think Trey might be one of three, maybe?
No, but I mean, like, do numbers exist in their language?
Yeah, they have words for them.
I don't understand. They don't have the word three, do they?
They pronounce them differently.
This isn't making any sense to me.
Like Trey. I think Trey is one of them.
Isn't that just a French person's name?
No.
I think it is. Trey Parker. I know him.
That's not a French guy.
You're right, it's not.
That's the guy that made that basketball movie.
You're right.
It's the only thing he ever did.
Yeah, he's never had anything else.
Yeah, actually, no, he did make something else.
He's basically a loser.
Made Cannibal the Musical.
He made some other musicals,
too. Have you ever heard of that?
No. Do I want to?
Doubt it. You hate musicals. But obviously, it wouldn't be a normal musical if he made it.
I love Footloose.
You know what? Okay, viewers, I don't know if you've seen this video. I'm guessing you haven't, but there's this great video you viewers should watch. Can I tell them about this, Pants? Do you mind if I do a promotion here for a video?
Sure.
Okay, there's a video out there, and I don't know what it's called.
That's going to be a problem.
So, but what happens is that in it...
Look at that. That moon looks like Robin Williams.
And when I'm saying this to you viewers, yes, it does. I'm saying to you viewers that this video hasn't gone viral yet, but it might have by the time that this video is posted. So what basically happens in this video is these two girls are doing Irish dancing.
Oh.
All right. I thought
you were going to say something about a cup.
Oh, Pants, why do you do that? Oh, don't even go there, Pants. I'm going to ignore that you said that, okay?
Okay, deal.
Viewers, I apologize for Pants bringing that up. I apologize deeply for that. It's like the worst thing he's done in any LP yet. Okay, what would Billy DMC do right now? I don't know.
I think you'd say, what are you talking about?
Okay, so...
It's my guess.
All right, I'm not going to say anything about that, viewers, about that. Okay, let's just move on. Okay, so in this video, there's these two girls doing Irish dance, all right? When Irish dance is one of my favorite types of dance, you know? One of my absolute favorite types of dance to watch. You know, I love Irish dancing.
I thought we were still talking about musicals. I was just talking about the Cup Song.
Okay. Yeah, the Cup Song is pretty cool. So anyway.
What's that musical called?
I forget.
Pitch Perfect.
Step It Up or something?
No, it's called Pitch Perfect.
Oh, Pitch Perfect, yeah. Something like that, yeah.
Yeah, it's called Pitch Perfect.
Okay, anyway, so in this video, these two girls are doing Irish dance out in the rain. Okay?
Oh, that's cool.
They're doing it in the rain, so it's raining while they're doing it.
They're just keeping it real.
And they're kind of like doing it in the like there's puddles around and everything.
Why did I keep going in that?
And they're doing like puddles, like click, 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 you know, Irish dance. And then finally, when this girl's done the Irish dance, the second girl, she's done dancing, she says, boom, like that, you know, to signify that she's done the dance, and there, that's it. I mean, Irish dancers don't usually do that or anything, but this girl does, all right? She's just having some fun. She's just like, yeah, that's my dance kind of thing. She says, boom. And right when she says boom, right after that, like a second after she says boom, this huge bolt of lightning behind her comes down. And then there's this big... loud thunder goes boom. It's just incredible that it happened right after she said that when she finished the dance.
Well, she's Zeus.
And then she's like, ay-y-y-y-y-y-y-y. And then she gets scared and like runs towards the camera.
Is she a mouse?
No. It's a great video. It is great. And I'm gonna show it to Pants after we're done.
Some sort of weird titmouse.
Oh, man.
What?
I can't believe this, Pants. Viewers, can you believe Pants? I spit all over my screen. That's how I can't believe Pants. Oh. All right.
What did I do?
I'm not even going to say, viewers. I'm not even going to say. But I'm going to bet that thin fried tofu, and maybe others are going to write in the comments that they think Pants is trying to sabotage the LP. Well,
maybe they should just Wikipedia titmouse or something. You know? Do some biology lessons or something. Right?
Why did you pick that particular mouse for the that you say it was a girl that a mouse. Why did you pick that mouse?
Because it's really small.
It is a small mouse.
It's among the smallest of the mouses.
So that's the reason you picked that.
I think it's known for being particularly small.
Okay, we'll go with that.
That's what I would do.
Billy MC, he's gonna, you know, if he watches this, he's gonna be like...
What, are you telling me that tit mice, no one's allowed to talk about them anymore?
He's gonna have his hat on, and he's gonna be like, he's gonna have his head in his hands, and he's gonna be like, oh, I can't believe that pants. That's what he's gonna be doing.
Man, tit mice, I think, have the right to be.
So
and
first,
I think you should be taking that
again,
away.
I apologize for pants. Well, you got farther in the level, pants.
No, I didn't.
So anyway, that's a great video, though. You should go watch that, viewers. I don't know what it's called. It's looking like Irish dance and, I don't know, rain or thunderstorm or something or lightning. I don't know. Who knows, right?
Boom.
Boom. Yeah, boom. Maybe boom. I don't know.
Oh, boy. That hand didn't reappear, did it?
It did, but you jumped too early.
Oh.
All right. What does that say? Rest.
What was that?
Rest. You can rest there. Why don't you rest there? Because, you know, maybe you need a rest.
Yeah. I need something.
This genie's hands are...
I think there's an extra life over here somewhere that I was trying to get before I... You know, jumped in a hole. Because that's like my
You know who else's face was in a moon?
Move. Andy Kaufman?
Jackie Gleason.
Oh.
In the Honeymooners.
Well, Andy Kaufman was the man on the moon.
Yeah, but his face wasn't in a moon.
What's the difference? I don't even know.
It's completely different. It's like that. His face was in the moon. A man who... Did you know at one time people used to think there was a man in the moon?
Like, yeah, of course.
It was a face, you know?
People thought a lot of dumb things.
They also thought the moon was made of green cheese.
Well, this is it.
Of course, viewers, if you know one of the very first movies that was ever made was had a rocket ship that went to the moon, and there was a face on the moon. And then,
Is it called Wallace and Gromit?
When the, no, it was from, like, 1902 or something like that. And, the face in the moon, when the rocket smashed into it, it had a look of disgust on its face because it had a rocket smashed into it. It's quite crazy. A famous image from the very earliest days of film.
See that life?
And it was also an amazing piece of animation, you know, for 1902. I mean, it's... Pretty much didn't exist then, animation, you know, because movies were just starting. So it was quite amazing, quite amazing.
I think that's a great way to die if that's what I want to do.
If it was animated at all, I forget. I think it was.
I'm not gonna do that next time.
I mean, it couldn't have been a real rocket, obviously. You know, okay, viewers, let's
yeah, that would be the most.
Chances. Let's see.
That'd be the most expensive movie ever made if it was a real rocket.
And, of course, they didn't have the... I mean, that was amazing special effect for 1902. Are you kidding me, viewers? That was unbelievable. In the early days of film, viewers, when people first saw movies, they're like, wow, the pictures are moving on a screen because, you know, nobody has seen this. It was an incredible thing to see. So some of the earliest movies were just film strips of trains, you know, coming towards you on the screen and things like that. And when that would happen, women would faint in the audience. The train would be coming towards them. They'd faint because they'd think, the train's going to come. It's going to run over us, you know, because they never seen this. Like, can you believe this? It's coming out of the screen, you know. What
I don't believe your story.
They were worried it was going to come out of the screen.
If that's what you're asking.
What?
I don't believe your story if that's what you're
asking. No, it's true. It's absolutely true.
Well, I don't believe it.
You can look this up.
I believe that you could look it up, but I don't believe it's true.
It's true, absolutely true. Absolutely true. People would
faint. These were some pretty dumb women, weren't they?
People would faint in the theaters because they'd never seen moving pictures on a screen. Right, and then the train be coming at them. They'd be afraid it was actually coming towards them. It was but actually coming out of that screen.
You know? It was very low fidelity, though.
Well, it's just, you know, it's a moving picture.
Yeah, but it was low fidelity.
And I don't know if Pants is aware, but in the early days before their sound was on film, before it was recorded on film, people used to play the piano or the organ. They'd hire somebody to do that while the film was playing, so they'd have music while the film was playing, and it would go with the soundtrack of the movie. Like, they try to play appropriate music for what was going on. So if there was a romantic scene going on in the movie, they'd play, you know, a romantic song or something like that. And if there was a chase scene going on, or like Harold Lloyd was climbing a building or something, or Buster Keaton was running down a hill with all these rocks chasing him or something, you know, then they'd play like fast chase music, you know, exciting music like that, you know?
Wow. That wasn't a sarcastic wow for your story, by the way. Okay.
So viewers, if you haven't seen that movie, Seven Chances with Buster Keaton, where all the rocks are coming after him, it's a very entertaining movie.
Probably haven't.
Pants used to love that movie when he was a kid. Remember that?
I do.
And of course, the famous movie with Harold Lloyd climbing the building and hanging off the face of the clock is from Safety Last. That is amazing. Amazing movie. And he had to remember, too, the special effects back then, they didn't have, like, ability for much of that. So almost everything was either done by the actors themselves or stuntmen that would, you know, risk their lives for everything, you know? Because there were no special effects, basically. Very few back then. Very few.
Wow, look at the size of that hand.
Occasionally, but it was a dangerous time. It was a dangerous time, but it was an exciting time.
Did you see that?
Yep.
That was ridiculous. What's down there? Oh, can I get that?
I don't think you should try. Oh, wow. Okay.
I got it.
Your gel pants.
There was another one there for me to get. I just realized, but I didn't get it.
So, I was going somewhere else with this, but I forget what it was, though.
Damn you, Jafar.
Oh, yeah, some guy made a comment on a video. Free from the magic lamp, the genie helps Aladdin escape the Cave of Wonders.
Jafar is a jerk. Maybe.
With the lamp in his possession, Aladdin races back to the palace of Agrabah and Princess Jasmine. Is this it?
Oh, we get to see her giant eyes.
Does she have big eyes?
I told you before, it takes up like a quarter of her face.
I didn't know that. You are talking about her eyes, right?
Yes.
Okay. I'm not familiar with her that well, you might so.
She was... You know that song?
Giant Eyes?
Show you the world.
You know what's a good song by the Grassroots? Where Were You When I Needed You? You know what's a better song by the Grassroots?
Grass.
My opinion is Only When You're Lonely. That's a really good song. You know what's another good song by the Grassroots?
Pesticide.
It's called, what's it called, viewers? Innocent Eyes or something like that? It's something Eyes. Somebody's going to know. It's something Eyes. Temptation Eyes. That's what it's called. Temptation Eyes. Yeah, that's a good song.
These eyes.
But Only When You're Lonely. I love that song. That is it.
I'm calling you.
Oh, yeah. So this guy made a comment in one of our videos. And someone said something. I wasn't sure exactly what he meant, but he said, I'm guessing 100 years old. And I thought what he meant, like, I don't know, what do you think? I think what he meant is he was guessing that I'm 100 years old. I'm around 100 years old.
Yeah, that's about right. It's pretty accurate.
But he's wrong, though.
Mm. Oh, no.
If you're watching the video now, you're wrong. I'm 18. And that's it.
Give me some heart.
I can't believe that Billy MC, though, he's 28 already. You know, I feel like he should be younger than that. And I don't mean that in that way. Don't take it that way. It's just that it seems like he's... it seems like only just yesterday when he was like 21 or 22, you know. I can't believe he's 28 already. That's what I mean by that. He's the same age as my girlfriend, Kat Dennings, which I comment on one of his videos and said
that. They should date.
No, because she's my girlfriend. He's dating Beth Bears, actually.
You're a friggin' girlfriend hog.
You bet it is. I am.
Yeah, you bet it is.
All right, so this is Pants playing a game called Disney's Aladdin for the Sega Genesis, released in, I don't know, 1993 or 2 or something, or 3 probably. I think it's 1993. He's got 3,050 points. He's got quite a bit of health at this point. He's on a magic carpet, and he's flying around in the air. He has a sword, or a knife, and he's, like, knifing everybody. He's got that guy, you know, he's got apples now. He's got one life left. I don't know how many continues. I don't know how he's got that. He's got 12 gems. He's got 25 apples. And in case you just tuned in, that's what's going on.
We really did have a lot of continues, eh?
Yeah, definitely.
Hey, look at that.
There's a life.
How do I get it now?
Should just jump back and got it.
I know that. Hit.
It's by accident, not on accident.
How many times has this come up?
I hate when people say that. But I love all of you viewers except for like one or two guys.
Except for the ones that say by accident.
No.
Wait, on accident.
No, I still like you guys, but...
Oh, that's good.
Remember, it's by accident. Not on accident. I don't know who started that. It only started, like, a few years ago. Because it, you know, for what, 50, 60 years, everyone knew it was by accident. And I'm guessing it's in some really stupid popular song or something. Or some dumb entertainer that did it, that didn't know how to speak properly, and then people started imitating them. That's my guess.
I highly doubt it was in a song.
That's my guess.
Is there an effer over here still?
No.
Give me that. Give it to me. Give it to me, baby. I got it.
I'm gonna do... No.
Hey, do you remember when music on television was a big deal? Those were the days.
Of course I do. That was great.
It was a lot of fun stuff.
Yeah, it was great when they used to have music videos and...
You know what killed MTV / Much Music? Because I did.
Reality shows?
No.
Bad music?
They had to put reality shows on out of necessity. They didn't want to, I'm sure.
YouTube? The internet?
Yeah, YouTube, yeah, for sure.
Obviously, yeah. But anyway, I'm reading in my... I have a... viewers, I have one of the largest collections of humor magazines in the world, from the 1950s to the present, and I love to read them all the time. Right now I'm reading my humor magazines from 1985. So there's all these jokes in these articles about music videos, because that was literally when MTV was like at its peak. It was about 1985. Everybody wanted to watch it. It was a big thing with young people. I want my MTV. And they'd be glued to it. It'd be so exciting to see your favorite, you know, music video on the channel. And you remember, that's right after, like, Michael Jackson's Thriller came out. And it, you know, revolutionized music videos by having a big, long story with it and all these special effects and all this kind of stuff, you know. I like the old music videos the best, the ones that are people call are cheesy, because I like the weird things that they used to do in them and the cheap kind of, you know, settings they have. I like that better than the slick stuff. I think it's more more interesting. Of course, I like older music better, too. But yeah, and another thing that you might not know, viewers, is that music videos didn't actually start with MTV. They were around before that. I mean, that's when they started to get popular. But they've been around for years and years before that. Back in the 1940s, there were things called, in 50s, there were things
called... I don't know how to beat this boss.
That's okay. There were things called soundies. Soundies. And they were basically music videos. Telescriptions as well.
Okay.
And then in the 60s, somebody came up with a brilliant idea they thought it was a brilliant idea to have jukeboxes, because jukeboxes, I don't know if you know what those are, viewers, but they used to have them like in diners and restaurants, but in malt shops, you know, where people.
That's what the Fonz would.
Yeah, exactly. They have them like in malt shops, soda shops that they go to like in the '50s and have sodas and everything and eat food, and there'd be a jukebox. You put a quarter in and you get a record or a dime or whatever it was. It'd play records. So anyway, somebody got the idea in the '60s to create a jukebox that showed music videos. Instead of just playing a record, it would show a music video. So these music videos were invented in France, and they're called Scopitones. And then somebody, an investor in the U.S., got the idea, this is a great thing to invest in. We're going to put these all over America. It's going to be great. They were very unusual-looking jukeboxes with these big video screens on them. And the Scopitones, I'm not going to read this. The Scopitones, I'm too into this story. The Scopitones were really crazy videos. They were in color. They were in color, for one thing, which was, you know, kind of rare for that time. And because they weren't movies, you know. And and they had all these like beautiful girls in them, with in various states of undress usually.
That's disgusting.
And the performers would lip sync their songs, and it was really like they're crazy. The videos are funny. They're really great to watch, though. Some of them have great music, and some of the music is not as good, but it's really fun to watch.
Wow.
And of course, my favorite Scopitone, probably the most famous Scopitone of all time, is Neil Sedaka's Calendar Girl. That's right. That's a Scopitone. It was made for music video jukeboxes. So look that up, Neil Sedaka's Calendar Girl, in the video with all the girls and everything in color. He's playing the piano, and he changes his suit several times during the video. And it's really exciting. It's a great song. And Neil Sedaka is my favorite singer from the 50s. And 60s. So there you go, viewers. If you wanted to know, now you know. So that's a great music video. It's a great song. That's my favorite music video of all time as well. So what happened with this was it didn't go off the way people thought it would. It didn't really catch on, these strange big jukeboxes. And I guess it might have been kind of like costly to have them around and the maintenance and stuff like that. And so eventually they just put them in a back room somewhere. And they say that there are some old, you know, shops somewhere in some places where if you go in the back room, you might see this weird-looking jukebox with a video screen on it. And it would be a Scopitone machine. Yeah, the investors lost a lot of money on that, too. They actually had. Now
whoever invested in MTV made a lot of money.
This is interesting. Now, you know how MTV has music video awards and other music networks have their video awards. Well, they actually had, in the 60s, they had probably, I would guess this must have been the very first music video awards ever. It must have been, because it was a music video awards for Scopitones. That's right. There was a Scopitones award show. It was going to be held every year, but I believe they only held it once, and it was a disaster. It was almost a disaster. I don't think hardly anybody cared about it or went to it. And one of the women that won, January Jones, and it's not that January Jones, the one today, but obviously a singer from back then who was never really that famous, actually.
That's such a neat name. I couldn't imagine anyone could have, more than one person could have it.
But she was never really famous, like even back then, but I think they named her Miss Scopitone. I think they named her Miss Scopitone at the award show. And when she went to accept her award, she tripped and broke her foot or toe or something like that. So, I mean, they said this was a harbinger of things to come because, you know, they lost money on it, went bankrupt. There was one video especially that ruined it for them because they made this video. It was, which one was it? It was a Mighty Mississippi or something, a song about a Mississippi, and it was like a folk group doing it, I believe. I'm not sure what they were called. I don't know if they were the Back Porch Majority or something. I don't think that was it. I can't remember who they were. But anyway, in the video,
gotta get up there.
In the video, they went farther than they usually did. Now, it wasn't unusual in their videos to have girls in their underpants.
Get me off of here.
Girls in their underpants and things like that going on in the videos and, you know, and underwear and stuff like that. So the videos are pretty risque for the time, you know, pretty raunchy and everything. But in this particular video, they had some angles that...
Yeah, those were hot.
With the girls, if you know what I mean. Some camera angles that really drew the ire of people that were offended at that. And so they, you know, they were like, this is, we don't want to have this.
The ankle angles.
And that kind of like was the end of Scopitones after that, you know. By the way, one of the people that invested in Scopitones at the beginning was Debbie Reynolds. I don't know if you've heard of Debbie Reynolds or not, but she's a very famous actress. And she's still alive today. I think she still probably makes movies today. She's probably like 80 or supposed to be like 80 something now. But she invested in them. And she liked it. She had a hit. She had a big hit in the 50s called Tammy in 1957. And she starred in the movie Tammy and the Bachelor, which was one reason it became a big hit, you know, because she starred in the movie and she sang the theme song. It's a beautiful song, number one hit, 1957. Look that up. Great song. And then if you want to hear a version that's a little faster, listen to the Ames Brothers version on one of my music channels, because that's really good, too. It's really good. Yes, I have music channels. That's right, viewers, I do. I am that Lime Popsicle that has the music channel on there. You see that guy? That's me, too. Okay.
Are you in the condition?
No, I don't do things to put myself in a condition. I don't imbibe, you know, or whatever. So I'm just enjoying my stories right now.
You're permanently in a condition?
Yeah. So viewers, Debbie Reynolds invested in the Scopitones, and she wanted to make sure that the first Scopitones that were done in America were her own. So she gave herself a huge production, you know, doing some of the big songs of the day, like If I Had a Hammer and We'll Sing in the Sunshine. Now, I do like Debbie Reynolds' Tammy. I like some of her other songs, but I don't know about her Vegas-type versions of those two songs in the Scopitones. They're not my favorite Scopitones. They're extremely, like highfalutin, you know. So,
Oh, no.
So, anyway, I don't know why.
This is the main final boss tonight.
What?
I think this is the final boss.
I think it is, too. So, viewers, I just like talking to you about things, you know. I just like telling you stories about history and, you know, popular culture history. I enjoy that.
Crap.
So, I did, and there you are.
I missed.
If you're wondering, another one of my favorite Scopitones is called Old Bill. No, it's not called that. Sorry, viewers. It's called Good for Nothing Bill. That's what it's called.
Ugh.
It's a really good song. I like the girl in it. There's the lead in it. I think she looks kind of cute. So look that up.
Do you like Hang on Sloopy?
We'll talk about that soon. Okay, so I also like a Scopitone called Scopitone Party. It's a French Scopitone. Where she's like, I love Scopitones, or something like that. I forget. But it's really cute. Like, she's cute, and, like, called Scopitone Party. I like that. There's a lot of good Scopitones. France Gall made some Scopitones. Francois Hardy made Scopitones. Francois Hardy. Neil Stack, of course, I already said. Bobby V, another one of my favorites. He made a great Scopitone of Babyface. Babyface, there you are. And one called Pretty Girls Everywhere. And he made, of course, a famous Scopitone for The Night is a Thousand Eyes, one of his biggest hits. It's a great one. Who else made Scopitones? They were great. Paul Anka made one for Remember Diana. That was really good. Bobby Rydell made one for Valencia or something like that at a ski resort. That's a pretty neat one, you know. And, oh, the famous B-movie actress, Joy Lansing. She made some really, really sexy Scopitones. If you want to see that, just look up Joy Lansing and Web of Love, or The Silencers. And you'll swear if you see the one for The Silencers, you'll swear she's not singing about actual silencers, but something.
This LP is getting a little bit too racy for me.
When you want to go to the Hang on Sloopy thing?
Yeah.
You still, really?
Yeah, let's talk about that.
All right, well, that video...
What the hell am I supposed to do here?
Okay, I'm not sure, like... There's something about that video that makes me think that maybe it wasn't made in the 60s. I don't know, it just... It looks more like the 70s to me.
Why does that matter?
It just looks like the 70s.
What does that have to do with anything?
Well, you asked about the video.
I kind of want to quit this. Yeah, but why does it matter if it's from the 60s? Or the 70s? Like, I don't even know what that means.
That's what this whole thing was about. You're, like, wondering how they...
No, it's just a movie. It's just a music video that you like.
Yeah, I'm not a big fan of the song, but the music video is pretty cool.
Well, there you go.
Well, you're going to be, like, giving the viewers the, you know.
No, don't.
Hey, come on now. Hey, I could do that. Billy MC talked about how he liked this Katy Perry and some other girl did a singer girl. They did a chest bump at an award show, and he's talking about how much he liked that one time.
Did they?
Yeah, that's what he said in a video. So,
cool.
So dude, so you know, Billy and C and I, we are, you know, we're guys, you know, and Pants is too.
I don't know who you're like defending yourself against.
You know, I mean, it's just the way it is. You know, viewers, you know. But anyway.
This is
Cat Dings.
This is too difficult for me. I want to just quit the game.
Cat Dings is my girlfriend, and she is very beautiful. I think Cat is beautiful, most beautiful girl in the world. You know, from head to toe, she's beautiful, and I think she's great personality too. Like she's very funny, and I don't mean in Two Broke Girls because. Well, I'm going to tell you something, viewers.
Really bad things happen when you're not distracted by a game and you don't have to. Pay attention.
What?
I didn't say that. Keep going.
I don't understand what you mean.
Keep talking.
Wasn't that an insult?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
I thought you were just talking about how you're having trouble in the game.
No. I am, for sure.
Well, what did you mean by that?
I meant you go on long-winded rants about nothing.
It's not about nothing. Viewers, I'm talking to you. This is...
Oh, my
viewers,
mistake.
I'm telling you things that I think are interesting.
I didn't mean to thwart it.
And maybe you'll think they're interesting too, viewers. You know, I like to talk to you. Well, this is the Lime Popsicle. He likes to tell you about, you know, things, about pop culture and stuff, you know? So I like to do, viewers. Yeah?
Don't worry, they weren't complaining. I was.
That's why I like having the... I used to like having when we did shows like Lime Popsicle and Pants discuss things. So I'm discussing things now, you know, in this video. I'm not playing, so I'm discussing things.
Yeah, go ahead.
I did.
You stopped, though.
Yeah. But I mean, in real life, Cat
is
funny. That's what I mean by that. I don't mean in the show, necessarily.
I don't think funny is the right word. I think quirky is the right word.
The problem with that is Cat hates the word quirky.
She said
once that if a guy calls a girl quirky, it means that they don't understand them. So she hates it when guys call her quirky. That's what she said. But she, otherwise I would have agreed with you, but you know.
Ouch.
But she says riddles and things like she's very cryptic in her Twitter comments and. You know, you have to figure out what she means, and I'm guessing most of her followers have no clue, and they don't even think about it, but I like to think about it. I like to, you know, I'm more interested in Kat than the casual, you know, fan that just is like...
Hardly.
...says the same thing all the time, you know? Like, So anyway, what do you mean hardly?
Bit of an exaggeration. You hardly really care.
He's being sarcastic right now, viewers. You probably don't know that because you don't know that unless you know me. But he's being sarcastic right now.
He's trying to push the Lime Popsicle's button a little bit. And it usually works a little bit better than it just did. Doesn't it?
Pants has a way of saying the word button like a little boy that's really, really hilarious. I think it's funny stuff. Do it.
I don't know that I can do it like I used to.
Button. It's sort of like that.
I think you might do it better than I can.
Batten.
Batten.
And then he said once Pants said, and again, viewer warning on this, but if you have children watching this, tell them to close their ears right now. Cover their ears. Because Pants said one time, if he like was with a girl and he was being a little boy, it wasn't exactly like this, but he said he could say to her, "Time to lose those battens." That's it. You can listen again now, children.
Weird.
He means on her. Okay, I think you know what he means.
I think that'd be a major turnoff. I'm just gonna guess. I could be wrong.
Unless that's a thing they're into, you never know.
Little boys?
No! That's not what I meant, viewers. I meant you talking as if you're a little boy.
Okay.
I'm an elephant.
Doubt it.
You're right, I'm not.
I gotta get all these apples.
Hey, viewers, is Deceased Crab still making videos? I know I can just Google, I could just YouTube him, but I haven't in a long time. I'm assuming he is.
Yeah, don't answer that question.
You can answer it.
No, don't, just because he should have just looked it up if he wanted to know. Don't do his...
I'm just doing it for the sake of conversation.
I don't think it counts as conversation.
Alright.
This boss is annoying. I've watched
him such a long time,
I'm not into this. This isn't cool.
Final boss, so it's difficult.
Yeah. I'd rather just end the game here.
That's what happens when I get to final bosses a lot of times. I just feel like ending the game. I usually do. Because I can't be bothered, you know? I can't be bothered. I mean, it's only a final boss. I'm not a fan of final bosses. I mean, it's just like, yeah, what's the fun in that? I played the levels. It was fun. Why do I want to do this, you know? I mean, a lot of people are getting the final bosses. To me, it's an anti-climax. You know? That's what it is to me.
Ouch.
It's anti-climatic. That's what it is to me.
The thing is, I've realized that I can actually do this literally forever, because when I die and have to use my continue, during this level I can make up enough. I can get enough jewels to buy a continue.
So viewers, this LP is going to go on forever.
I think we'll just go with this continue.
You know, I'm going to look up Deceased Crab, viewers.
If I don't beat it this time around, then screw it.
Okay, so Deceased Crab, is the last video he posted was 2 months ago.
I'd say he's still going, then. That counts as current for me.
He's been making videos with this Madam Luna, who's another LP'er, for years and years. I always figured that he's dating her. I wonder if they're married or something now. Other than him, I'd never heard of her anywhere. Maybe she's popular. I haven't a clue. I don't watch most of the popular LPers. I watch people that aren't that popular. But, of course, my favorite one now is the Mexican Runner. And I barely watch anybody else anymore because it takes up all my time watching him. Because he posts videos all the time. He's trying to... In case you don't know, I've mentioned this in almost every LP lately. He's trying to beat every NES game ever made. And he's doing a good job at it. So go watch his channel, The Mexican Runner. It is fun to watch him try.
Is he going to move on to Super Nintendo afterwards?
I hope so. I really, really hope so.
Isn't there a lot more Super Nintendo games than Nintendo games?
I don't know if there's a lot more, but I think there probably are more. But I'm going to tell you something funny. Somebody else had said to him, somebody should do it for Sega games, which it's true, they should. And also somebody said, hey, a Mexican Runner, after you've done Nintendo, what are you going to do next? Are you going to do DOS games? And I thought that was absolutely hilarious that they said that.
Why?
Because how in the world could you beat every single DOS game? Do you know how many DOS games there are?
That's a good point. No, I don't.
I looked up a list of DOS games once because I was trying to find all the DOS games that were platformers. I wanted to know every single one. And I looked it up, and there must have been something like 4,000 or so, at least, DOS games.
This is where the scrolling thing that you talked about really comes into play.
I mean, there's so many that it would be impossible for anybody to take on that challenge. But it'd be fun to watch, though. Do you think he will do that if he beats all Nintendo games? You know, and I think he probably will, but do you think he will go on to something else, do another, like SNES? You think he would do that?
I don't know.
I hope so. But one thing he mentioned about SNES, he said one reason he picked NES is because the games are shorter, so they're more, you know, you could beat them fast. Like with SNES, they're longer, you know? Mm. And of course, some of the Nintendo games, like the RPGs, are incredibly long, though. I think the longest it's taken him so far to be a game is around 37 hours or so.
Damn it.
I'd be interested to know if any of our viewers watch The Mexican Runner.
Yeah.
If any of you start watching him because I've mentioned him in these videos, please go tell him that Lime Popsicle has sent you to him. and tell him about our channel, Lime Popsicle and Pants.
Why?
Because you tell him that I'm promoting him, and maybe he'll do a shout out or something.
Interesting.
I think that would be really cool. I'd love that.
This boss is bullshit.
What? Oh.
This boss is bullshit.
Okay, don't repeat your bowel language again.
This boss is bull poopies.
Why don't you just say, this boss is not to my liking?
Really?
Well, that's what a Harvard graduate might say.
A Harvard graduate graduated in 1900, sure.
Yeah, exactly. That's when people were more civil.
Yeah. See, look at this.
In some areas.
This isn't fair. Oh, I can run on this.
Dude, people wore big hats back then, sometimes.
I didn't know I could do that.
Well, I don't think.
Oh, crap. Just when I learned how to do it, the game ended. It's over.
Still going.
No, it's over.
I like to make a shout out to Violet's voice. Go tell her to watch our videos, viewers. No. Yeah, you can if you want, but if you're pressed for time or you're saying, oh, I can't do all this, just do let me ASMR it.
I want to make a shout out to Monica Bellucci.
You did that already, I think.
No, I don't. Probably did someone else. Yeah. You want me to do someone else?
Selma Hayek or somebody.
I want to make a shout out to Donald Trump for watching our videos.
So that was the end of this LP.
Donald S. That's his YouTube name.
Is it?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah. We should start a PayPal soon so he can donate $1 billion.
Hey, if any of you want us to start a PayPal so you could donate money to us, let me know.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to use it for, like, video games. I'll just use it. But I mean, if you just, like, you're like, hey, you know what? I'd like to give LimePopsicle money because I like his videos, then, yeah, feel free to do it.
All right, good stories.
Your turn.
Which way should I go?
I don't know.
Left. Oh.
Hey, Pants.
A boo. Yeah.
Oh, I want to address something else.
Look at that cool Sega logo. That's so cool.
I've been trying to get Billy MC to do...
Look at that. Richard Branson made this game.
I've been trying to get Billy MC to do an interview with me.
1993.
For this channel for a long, long, long time. And if you watch his channel, and most of you probably do, you'll see that he said in one of his latest videos that he's going to do it. He's going to do at that talk show. So I want you all to support this. You know, I want you all to, if you're interested in that, do tell Billy MC. Say, Billy MC, we really want to see that. Because I want to see that. I want to interview Billy MC. I think it'd be really fun to learn more about Billy MC with you, with the viewers. I have some great questions to ask him about his origins in the video game industry. That's not what I mean to say, but...
Yeah, I heard he got bit by a spider.
No, I mean his how he got into... Well, I don't want to give the questions away. I mean, that would suck, you know, if I did that.
Yeah, let's do a textual interview.
I want to ask him questions about video games, about...
Email.
You know, just questions that I think the viewers would be interested to know about Billy MC, you know, to learn more about Billy MC. So, and if Pants is here, if he's here when Billy MC and I do the interview, if I can get him to be here, I want Pants to be here so that he can record it. Because I don't know how to record it. I mean, but also Pants could ask him some questions as well. I mean, it'd be fun for Pants to be there as well. Wouldn't it be fun to hear us all together, viewers, Billy MC, Pants, and the Line Popsicle? Wouldn't that be neat? You know, I think that would be really neat. So that's what I wanted to say. All right, so anything else you want to say, Pants?
Yeah.
What do you want to say?
Do you like fire hydrants?
Well, you know, they serve a very useful purpose. So
yeah.
I say yes, I do.
Like I wish more of them were red. They're all yellow around here, aren't
they? You
know
how they used to say, like, in the summer, kids would always take baths in the fire hydrants?
Yeah.
They'd loose it out, and then they go, oh, and they jump around in it and everything. Do kids still do that?
That's illegal, man.
Do they still do it?
Hoodlums, maybe.
I mean, people would let the kids do it. You know?
Excuse me, twice.
A thing where they'd be allowed to do it. You know, when the city people would say, hey,
yeah, it's called a water park, man.
No, it would be a fire hydrant. I mean, I've seen that. Like, I don't know if people do it anymore. Maybe it was only in the 50s or something.
You saw someone do it in the 50s?
40s and 50s. Well, not firsthand, you know, but I've seen it in my humor magazines and stuff.
Oh, okay.
And, you know, in pictures and stuff.
Hmm. Fair enough.
You ever taken a bath in a fire hydrant, Pants? Not in the fire hydrant, but, you know, turning it on and making the water come out of it. Because if you took a bath in the fire hydrant, I don't know how you do that. How would you do that?
You asked me this question already.
Did I?
Well, not the in part.
Just around it?
That's what you asked me earlier.
I forgot already.
A minute ago.
Man, I forgot that. That minute seemed like it was like a few months, you know?
Yeah.
Weird.
I guess.
So have you taken a bath in a fire hydrant?
No, you can't really get in it. Small puppy could maybe take a bath.
Well, I mean around it.
I told you no already.
Oh, see, I can't remember. It's just like, sorry about that, man.
I don't forgive you.
All right.
I guess I do.
Yeah, of course you do. Come on.
Yeah.
Well, okay, so what's your review of this game? What did you think about it? Obviously, you picked it, so you're going to give it a great review, I would think.
Sure.
Hello? What's your review?
It's good.
What do you give it out of 10, Pants?
Eight. 0.3.
That's not as high as I would think you'd give it.
Well.
All right. Well, it's a very good game. It's a very good game, you know. So I give it a very good game out of 10.
Cool.
Well, I guess that's all for today. You got anything else you want to say before we sign this LP off?
Yeah.
What?
Don't look up when someone says heads up.
You know,
extra. You said, cover your head. Yeah.
You think that if somebody says look up, you should just cover your head instead of looking up?
When they say heads up. Have you not heard that phrase before?
Yeah, I don't think that's a good idea.
They tell you, they say heads up because something's coming to your head.
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
Okay.
I obviously don't get that.
Okay.
But I think it'd be a better idea to look upwards while running quickly out of the way.
Hmm. I don't think the looking up part is really going to amount to anything.
I think it would be good to duck as well. To duck, you know, while you're running out of the way.
And looking up.
Yes.
So you're kind of in like a crouch position?
Yeah, a crouch position at an angle looking upwards running away would be the best thing, best reaction, I think.
Like 30 degrees?
Yeah.
Okay.
Isosceles triangle, you know.
Yeah, let's go with that.
All right?
Yeah, I think that's good advice for the viewers.
Before the viewers go home.
Yeah, you're going to say something about extraterrestrials?
Oh, thanks. Extraterrestrials, they can use nickels, you know. In some planets, nickels are their fuel for their spaceships.
It's weird that they would call them nickels.
Well, they come to Earth, they call them nickels because, you know, they know the Earth people and call them nickels, you know?
Okay. And then they just put them in their tank and...
Yeah.
Hmm. All right.
They can, instead of going to rock festivals, they go to festivals of fluids and temperatures.
So kind of like a rave or... What happened to you? Those are weird noises, man. That's obnoxious. Stop doing that. Hopefully that's the last time that ever happens. Are you possessed by Diddly or Dudley or whatever that thing's name is? That dog?
Okay, pants?
Yeah.
What was I going to say?
I think you said it all.
No, I had something else I was going to say just before, but I didn't say it yet, and that was on my mind. Can you tell me?
Yeah. I think it was about Ted Nugent.
No, not even close. Darn it.
I could have sworn.
What were we talking about before that?
Extraterrestrials using nickel as fuel.
Before that?
Fire hydrants.
No, after that.
And bats.
Bats?
About running away from things falling on your head.
Yeah. Was there anything between that and the extraterrestrials?
I don't think so. Maybe.
Okay, everybody? I don't know. Oh, before everybody goes home. Remember?
Yeah.
That's what it was. Before everyone goes home. Oh, right. Got it. Some of the people in our audience may be, you know, in school right now. They might be doing math problems, right?
At this exact moment?
Well, they may have a math problem they need to do for tomorrow, you know?
Okay.
And they're stuck on it, so they decide to watch this video, you know, because they stuck on the problem. So I want you to tell the viewers, I want you to help them with their math homework.
Yeah.
You do it.
The answer is 7.
No. It might be. If it is, write in the comments if the answer was 7 to your problem, okay? If the teacher tells you that, okay? if you don't know yourself. Or you look up in the back of the book if there's answers, you know. But what I want you to do, Pants, is give them a little more, you know?
Alright. Remember that the equal sign means something.
No. More than that. I want you to give them...
No, you gotta listen. I'm serious. This is something that teachers never
tell you.
I'm gonna
tell exactly what you need to tell them, but go ahead.
The equal sign is very important. It means that on both sides of the equal sign, it's the same number written two different ways.
So if you're
wondering how to solve something, remember that what you have on each side is the same number written two different ways. Yeah, I'm done. What do I need to tell them?
Tell them what the Pythagorean theorem is.
Pythagorean theorem?
The Pythagorean theorem, exactly.
It's, you want the equation?
They want it.
It's,
they need it for their homework. Help them. Is it x equals b equals y squared?
No.
See, look at that. Now they're going to get it wrong. You better tell them.
It's, one of the shorter sides of the triangle squared plus another one of the shorter sides of the triangle squared equals the longest side of the triangle squared.
That's great. Okay, so everybody now, Pants, helps with your homework?
That was a dumb way to say that.
Do you want to do it again?
It's the side, one of the sides of the triangle, right angle triangle, that is adjacent to the 90 degree angle squared, plus another side that is adjacent to the 90 degree angle squared equals the side opposite of the right angle triangle. Wait, right angle, square. That was not a good attempt.
You want to try again?
No.
Okay, so that's my advice.
R squared.
For you viewers. Is to do what Pants said, you know, when you're asked that, okay?
It's weird stuff.
Okay, so, and my advice to you is, it's fun to stay alive.
That's not really advice. You kind of need to, you know, it's implied advice, sort of, but, you know, you're making the viewers do extra work. The implied advice is stay alive.